to you. We just had a man in here today with his wife who has just recently arrived from Cuba after 25 years and 45 days in Mr. Castro's prison.
You look handsome in person and in photograph and television. That's true.
Well, thank you.
I'm really honored that you have taken this time, and we are fighting for you with all your ideas and your policies, and be sure that you can count on all the Cuban American women. Yeah, I'm the founder and the first president of the National Association of Cuban American Women.
Yes, I know.
Thank God.
Well, God bless you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Congratulations to Mrs. Reagan for her great work in the United States.
Oh, good. I shall tell her.
Thank you.
Hi, Karna. How are you? Mr.
President. Good to see you again.
Yeah, good to see you.
Hi. You know, Mr. President.
Yeah, sure. Hi, how are you? Nice to see you.
Hi, Mr. President.
Hello there, President. Good to see you. Hi. Well, you have a report.
brief one, if you're willing to accept brief reports this late in the afternoon.
Somehow I think I can make it. Yeah, I'm still struggling for that. Yes.
Truth, I said I feel like it's my wedding day. You know, I have to go on to something new and good for me, but I'm leaving a big hunk of myself back here.
Yes.
And I'll miss everybody. You.
We'll miss you.
Thank you.
We'll all wish you well.
Thank you
for all that you've done.
Thank you. You ready to go?
Well, now wait 1 second.
Oh my.
I can't leave without a few souvenirs. This one's for you.
Thank you.
This one's for you.
Thank you.
And I know you must read books, you know, and then have to put them down before you do the bookmarks over.
Thank you.
Maybe that'll encourage them to read, too.
Yes.
Something special to mark them with. Thank you.
Let me tell you, you get to reading books, you'll never be lonely if you have a book.
That's true.
To me, the worst fate in all the traveling I've done is to ever find myself in a hotel room someplace at night, and no book, nothing to read.
That's true. Well, thank you. Well,
we're
going to
do one group photo. Can we do one group photo over here in front of the door?
All right.
A family photo.
Shall we put these
Yeah, sure. Can we get Amanda right kind of in between the, right there.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Great. You can smile. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You know, isn't it awesome? The kid, you know how the kids use the word awesome? Everything is awesome. This office is awesome. It really is. No matter how many times you're in here, it is. I can't believe I'm standing here with you. Well, thanks. It's
thank
great.
You.
And here I am with my little family. It's been a kick. And I'm going to miss you.
Like I said, we'll miss you.
All right.
Good luck.
See you.
All right.
Thanks.
You bet. There you are.
Hi, Aaron.
How are you?
Nice
son Scott.
Hello there. President Bush.
And my son Jeffrey.
Hello there.
College students.
The Thomas have always been cry.
We don't. Get in the middle here for a picture.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Phil.
Well, I'm going to miss you.
I'm going to miss you. You know, it's been so long. Do you remember way back in January? It was real cold. And Brady and I were standing out in front of Blair House. And you came out and you made the announcement. And all the press was around. And, you know, that was like January 6th or 7th before you were inaugurated. And that was really neat. It was super. And the boys have been involved in things. They both managed the registration drives on campus to register Republican students to vote for you. At Denison and at SMU in Dallas. He flew up from SMU to see you today.
Oh, I drove over.
He's here. So they're all excited. And now it's time to turn over the mantle. Scott's been doing some advancing for the vice president.
We just came back from Cairo, vice president. Some interesting experiences over there, especially with motorcades. I had to clear the roads 3 hours in advance, and we still managed to lose the press bus one time because some camels decided to cross the road at a particular time.
Oh, all those new camels were useful.
They didn't get photo ops because they lost the press bus. Absolutely, it's terrible.
Cleared the roads 3 hours in advance.
We were coming in for an arrival.
Yeah, these are just key rings. And
Thank you.
Very much, sir.
Thanks, sir.
So neat. Well, I told Bob Tuttle and Admiral Poindexter and others that I'm going to take a job with Hill & Knowlton, which is the largest public relations firm in the world now. You know, they bought Gray & Company, your friend Bob Gray?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, Hill & Knowlton bought Gray, and they also bought Carl Beyer & Associates, another PR firm. So now they're the largest in the world with the combined operations. And I said, I want to keep doing things for you and for the administration, so what we can do in the private sector, whatever it is,
we'll be
based in Washington. It's just, it's a really good offer. You know, I mean, they came to me. Senior vice president, so we're happy. But I'm going to miss you.
Well, you're not that far away.
Well, I know.
That's why you have to come in on business.
Anyway, keep SDI.
Oh,
you
bet.
If I had to say one thing, that's what I wanted to say when I was in here. So that's to me the most exciting initiative.
I have to say, in our research, is ahead of what we thought, and is revealing that. Do you think it's going to be a practical thing that we can have? Get rid of those missiles.
Thank you. Young people are turned on to it, too.
Yes.
I mean, they really are.
Well, when everyone into video games, I actually understand it now.
Well, they do.
they're like space invaders. They can
it's a reasonable thing. It's a thing that the system is to start by getting them as they come out of their silos. Mm-hmm. And then those that get through that, get them high up and above the atmosphere, and then find them for any that may get through there, down low, pick off from ground-based thing. Mm-hmm. But the thing is, my own dream is that we could get a treatment where we share it with everyone in return for everybody getting rid of their missiles.
Mm-hmm.
And then say, this is like a gas mask when we had to get rid of gas. We all kept our gas masks.
Mm-hmm.
Any need for checking up.
Yeah, well,
they say they're gone, let's just be sure.
Then you wouldn't have to worry, or some madman coming along like a Hitler. You see, you can't write out of people's minds that we know how to make those things again.
That's right.
So, but you'd all be safe if we had this.
That's right. I mean, some people, I think, still see it as a nice little bargaining chip, and they still talk about it around town and the Congress and all that sort of thing. But I know how you feel. So
right.
Anyway, thank you, sir. We really appreciate it.
Good seeing you.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming up.
Oh, my pleasure. I hope to apply for your job in about 30 years.
All right. I won't stick around till
then. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Hi.
Chef Eisenhower.
Yeah. Nice to see you.
Well, nice to see me.
What a picture. Well, we'll miss you. I'm sure Jim will.
I will miss him a lot, Mr. President. He has been my finest colleague for
several years. He was a strong supporter of yours in 1980. He served on the Federal Training Commission transition team, and he came over here in 1981 and worked at OMB with me, and then went off and got a PhD so he could do you even better a job.
Well, thank you for everything.
Thank you, it's been an honor.
I got a little souvenir here for you. I want you to forget it.
Well, I won't forget. Never forget. Right. Thank you.
Okay. Right.
Thank you very much.
Good luck.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Okay.
Oh, why didn't I get a sign that was going to be tomorrow?
No.
That's one
or
the other.
What are you doing under there? That was me. That was me. Did you recognize the grip?
Well.
Henry Singleton has sent us a new kind of a... What are you doing? A new kind... Is he here?
Oh, yes.
Let's do it.
Now, this is...
Candace, the cork floor. It's the book. Three kids. Three pets. So.
It's okay. You want... Oh, all right.
He's going...
to HHS. Oh, wait, no, he just does that.
Yeah,
no. Pat Thompson's out. Let's...
Really?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've never heard of it before, but...
Did he have to eat all the ice cream he wanted?
Oh, they heard it. They loved it.
Hi, how are you?
That's Max.
Hi.
Hello there.
My wife, Maria.
Hi.
How are you, sir? Good to see you.
Max, can you shake hands with Mrs. Ray?
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Hi.
Just saw you a few minutes ago.
I just saw you a few minutes ago. Yeah. Just saying, we were in Harper's Ferry today.
We had fun there, too.
No.
Come on, fellas. Let's get a picture.
I think get a group.
Here.
Group
I'm going to cover you up, Rex.
Oh.
Seth, move back with that step.
Okay,
sense.
Right here. You can smile. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks.
No.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
We have a few little souvenir chests.
Oh, boy.
Yes, okay. Yes.
I gotta get it straight. Yes.
Whoops.
Well, you don't have the door yet. That's...
That's the one. It's for Mrs.
Yes. Yeah. I'm not that good as Santa Claus.
Yeah. Thank
you. I'm sitting here for you. Fellas, in here is a jar filled with jelly beans. But probably because someone won't want you to undo it before you get home, I'll give you the jar here. But just so you can tide you over, this is some samples of what's in the jar.
Oh, what do you say?
Well, you're more than welcome.
This has been such a privilege. Thank you so much. Oh, well. We're going to miss Ken, but he's going to be still with us in the drug, holy drug training.
I'll be right over there. And you know where to get me and how to get me.
I do.
Listen, it's been great.
Well, can't tell
you. I can't tell you how great it's been.
It's great for us. I'm glad that it's only just moving around within the shop.
Yeah, we'll be around. We'll be over there.
Well, both of you keep up the good work for us. We're very, very proud.
I just thought it was not enough to be a she not wouldn't necessarily say it because I was gone all the time. Why sure it was there. Thanks a million, man.
Thank you for everything. Yeah.
I'll see you again tomorrow.
I'll see
you.
Yeah.
Boy Scouts.
Yeah. Okay. Oh yeah.
Mr. President, it's been a real pleasure.
Yeah. Pleasure for us.
Thanks. Say goodbye, fellas.
Bye.
Bye.
Goodbye.
If they see you on TV, they say, there's President Reagan, there's Mrs. Reagan. And now they're scared to death. Okay.
Bye,
Rex.
Goodbye, Rex. He doesn't mean it.
He doesn't mean it.
You're used to it.